You know a way over the Teelson Pass. You told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on, I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done!
After everything I've... What about what you've done, old man? Huh? Sherman's camp, the things that
you did...
Hey,
you leave me!
Listen to me, listen to me! What if you could take it all back, huh? What if you could fix it? And after I put Sarah on a chopper, I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved. Mike, that's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right. If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass. You don't come back. All right, you promised me you don't come back.
I got you.
Shit, now I gotta talk to Boozer.
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands, thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was, every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. A bunch of goddamn refugees. Yeah. World belongs to them now.
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving. Isn't living. Something Jack used to say. Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to, but you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
You know, we never talked about it. While we still wore the colors all this time out in the freak show when shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Yeah, but I think. Last two mongrels on Earth, Farewell Originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
Yeah. We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
When we rode out of Farewell, without Sarah, without Jack, or anyone, I knew that we were leaving everything behind. Everything that mattered was gone. Except this.
You got Nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Come on, Jack. Inside, let's go. She's out there. You'll find her.
Deke, ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready.
Meet me at the gate. Don't keep me waiting.
Yeah, sure, Mike, whatever you say. Hey.
Heard Big Mike is taking you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made it, didn't we? If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up
like us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer. What'd you call us, campers? Yeah.
You go and you find your woman. You know where to find me.
And you know what? You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
You ready?
Yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
Come on, this way.
Okay, I'm following you.
Jack out fishing once, before, you know?
No shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
You ran a pretty tight club. Or you boys raised some hell back in the day. I don't think you murdered anyone. Not in cold blood.
It's not murder if they shoot at you first.
How many tourists we used to get through here come summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow, floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy-flops. All summer long they come. A trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here, nonstop.
Glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
The help.
I don't have a choice, Mike.
Fair enough. Come on, just follow me.
Yeah, okay.
This is as far as I go. Keep following the trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the Diamond-like Valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
I've memorized your face, just in case the name lasts me eternity. But life's for the living, I won't be giving up on you, on you. Even though I know you would tell me to.
If you're out there, I'll find you.
What the hell?
Jesus,
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on.
Hey, okay, all right, all right, all right. It's dead. It's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God.
I'm Russell, Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins. Rick.
Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south.
Freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay?
Fine.
He just killed a freaking ranger, dude. Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you 3 hots and a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you gotta. You'll be fine. Okay? Let's go.
Following you.
Deschutes County Militia?
Look, man,
How big's your outfit?
To camp out here? We got 100, maybe more. Hard to keep track. Back in HQ, a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, okay. Any women?
Hell, that what you're about? Well, you can forget it. Colonel's got rules about that. Fraternizing. Yeah, that. Look, you pull your weight, follow orders, nobody messes with you. Women same as the men. Don't matter to the Colonel.
I'm not... Listen, I'm looking for some people and a woman that I rode with a year back or so. They would have come over from Silver Lake, and they would have been at one of those Nero refugee camps, I think.
Silver Lake? Jesus, man. Silver Lake's been gone a lot longer than that.
Yeah. It's too goddamn easy to lose track of time out of here, you know? Anyway, you guys, do you pick anyone up? Survivors, I mean, from the refugee camp?
Maybe. Like I said, it's a big freaking army, you know? Ask the captain. He came in across the Salt Flats, I think. He might know.
The captain?
Yeah, Corey. He commands the Diamond Lake outpost. We're almost there. This is it.
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
Report.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here. And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
Are you interested?
I've been looking to settle down, yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
Come on.
So, how long you been drifting?
Hard to say. You lose track of time out there, you know?
So, where'd you get your gear? Ammo?
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
A few.
Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course?
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you. But the Colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Jesus, motherfucker has my ring. He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him. So that means that she's gotta be here. He doesn't look like militia.
Hey. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy Listen. Shit. Deacon St. John. Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You wait. See this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what, you joining up, becoming an army man, playing soldier and shit?
I don't know. Maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man, yesterday. Okay, yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people, we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah, come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents.
All right, then.
Who was in a goddamn wheelchair can run faster than you?
Moving!
Yes, sir. I should be in the mechanics area. She never knew a wrench from a screwdriver.
Anything else? Okay. See you later.
Hello. You are new here? I am Lumi Ikeda.
Deacon St. John, you're the bounty collector around here?
Yes, of course. We welcome anyone who will work to make the area safe.
Good.
Goodbye.
Maybe in here. Nope, not here.
One, two.
Check this one.
Follow the cadence.
The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right? Ah, damn it. She's not here either. It's gotta be the one. Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. Oh, God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but. Right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. Now, could it? You got a problem?
St. John, are you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah.
Go,
I'm here.
Go. You gotta move your ass! You think you're gonna outrun the freaks?
I'm
Hell no, you're not! Come on, you gotta work!
Yes! Yes! Sir!
Sergeant!
Sergeant!
Sir!
Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
So you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
Back there. I mean, it looks like a forest fire, but the stumps are charred. So that means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. From the outpost, we can see a horde coming long before it reaches us.
And what? You're gonna burn all the buildings too, so the newts and the swarmers have nowhere to sleep?
You know your freaks, huh?
Like I said, I've been out in the ship for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? The militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground?
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. We'll do whatever it takes to win.
A war?
That's what it is, isn't it? War? You've been out in the shit. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
We have a plan. The colonel lets you join, we'll fill you in. So, Silver Lake, you asked about survivors. Someone?
No, not really. I mean, look, there were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after something. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
This is it.
Hey, Corporal. The captain's here.
It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Oh, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez?
How long has Vasquez been with you guys?
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike.
God.
Where do we start?
It's been snowing, so there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
I can use this. You said he stole rations, ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front, which means that he went out the back. Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah. Come on, this way.
Hey, hold on for a second.
Look.
Over here.
Tracks?
Yeah, we're in luck. This way.
Wait, hold up. You find something?
Yeah. Shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
Is it infected?
Go on, get out of here.
What are you doing? That never worked for you.
Depends.
Look out, more wolves!
I see him. That's the last of them.
Yeah, it looks like it. Nice work.
Use everything. Okay, I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot, right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on, let's see if you're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here? The ones that aren't infected, I mean?
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Well, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
Hold up.
What is it?
It's a backpack.
It's one of ours.
Looks like they almost got to him.
And he shrugged off the pack to get away.
Nah. To buy time.
He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah.
Wait, get down. I swear.
Nero, gravesite.
This one's marked on our map. They're scattered all over the region.
Now, maybe that explains why Vasquez came through here. Let's go around.
Exactly what I was thinking. St. John, this way.
Yeah, right there with you. I gotta say, you're getting tired running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before.
You just gotta keep moving.
Man, look, if you're gonna join the militia, you must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, kinda goes hand in hand, doesn't it?
Okay, put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell the corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash-and-burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them just in this part of the state alone.
We gotta start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead, or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The Colonel will fill you in if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't...
Hey, wait. Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Well, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. Vasquez is there. What would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well... Do you see your man?
Yeah. That's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Come on, Vasquez.
Oh, see about that.
Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
Thank you.
not anymore.
Whew, okay. Wait here. Stand guard in case we missed anyone.
You can handle him?
He won't know what hit him. Door's jammed.
This is how it goes down.
I'm warning you, you asshole.
Oh, yeah, you're warning me.
Locked tight.
Damn funny.
Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay. I'm just gonna move over here.
Stay the hell away from me!
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a damn who you are?
Okay. How was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Vasquez?
Done. Way done.
Captain Curry? Come in.
This is Curry.
We're here. Heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
What about the enemy?
They've been, neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass?
Pass?
Oh, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was what? Some kind of test.
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah. You passed. Oh. You ready to meet the Colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
So, St. John. Where did you serve? Before the ship went down. Yeah, you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? I mean, first year out here, it seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, on a sack.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days. I want to show you something.
So are you familiar with this area?
Yeah, I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell, you know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, we stopped by here on our honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chival what?
No, it means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
So, where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
What would my mom say if she knew I was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker?
I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear your sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon, I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there, that's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
Oh, yeah, I bet. So, you know this is way past my bedtime, right?
Oh, I know.
Oh, come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project, and we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know, like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah, no problem.
Wait, is this a pop card? Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that. Pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah. I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, Deacon, what? Okay, I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on, keep following the trail. We're almost there.
You think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
God. God, look at that moonlight. It's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies. Oh, I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay, first of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it, and we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah? Deacon?
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're gonna ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one... The second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you just break your biker ring off my finger?
You know, I probably did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like clenching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me like a real ring, though, right? Not that this one's
not
absolutely,
great. Because I just thought that's my ring.
Right, it's your ring. Right. Something more simple, without fangs.
Okay.
Shit, I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab, I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello? Yeah. No, it's fine, I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know, they need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry, I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick. Let's go. Let's see.
Nothing like scrap.
Not unusual, you know.
I'm sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. When phones went away, when the cloud went away, our photos went with them.
Yeah, I guess I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie. Father was a photographer. Old school. Dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated him. Cell phones, I mean. Seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
You guys are taking this shit seriously.
Colonel believes with enough motivation and discipline, we can achieve anything.
Come on, hurry your ass up.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Just move it!
Is that your idea of motivation?
Colonel has set up a work camp on the south side of the island for those unfit to serve. Some of them require extra encouragement.
I'll bet.
Come on, follow me.
Yes, sir.
Stand up there with the others. Good luck, St. John.
Got your ass too, huh?
Whatever.
Hey, man. It's good to see you again. St. John, right? Son of a preacher man?
Taylor, what's this son of a preacher man shit you keep saying?
I'm just kidding with you, man. Hey, do you have any luck?
What?
The woman you were looking for, you and your peeps are riding with.
No.
I need all your jewelry, watches, shit like that. Come on, in the bag.
Sure, man, whatever you say.
The hell you say?
Recruits aren't allowed personal effects. Besides, shit's just gonna get stolen. Come on, cough it up.
Yeah, shit's gonna get stolen.
Goddamn bullshit.
Ten hot! At ease. Visitors are not welcome here. You are here because you were invited, recruited by my trusted officers. When you answer me, start by giving me your name, last name first.
Getting by, same as everybody.
Name.
Atkins, Crystal, sir.
How many men have you killed?
Before or after?
Answer the question.
Fuck you!
We've all done things that we're not proud of.
What?
To survive, to stay alive. The Almighty understands this.
Right.
The Almighty forgives this.
Amen! Amen!
But here, on this woman's face are the footprints of Satan. Prison tattoos. Proof of what you once were and no doubt still are. It's people like her that are responsible for bringing the wrath of the Almighty down upon us all.
Yeah, that's right.
Take her to the work camp.
What?
Fuck you.
Get her out of here. Fuck you.
Come on, gorgeous. Let's go.
Goddamn redneck asshole. Get off of me.
Swear to God.
What about you?
Get off me.
Taylor. Wait. And, no. Sir. I never been to jail. Never killed anyone. Nothing like that.
You've been in the shit for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, I know. I know how to shoot stuff. My dad took me hunting when I was a kid. He was at a camp near Klamath Falls.
And how about you, son? You know how to use a gun?
St. John, Deacon. Yeah, I know how to use a gun.
You're a drifter. Hold out your right arm. 10th Mountain. Iraq?
Afghanistan.
Honorable service, and don't lie to me. I'll know.
Served one tour, served with honor. Hated every goddamn minute of it.
Thou shalt not lie. Good man. Hold up your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to support and defend the new Constitution of these United States? Against all enemies, natural and unnatural, to bear witness and support to the same, and to obey all orders without question. So, do you swear?
I swear.
Dismissed! Walk with me, son. Captain Curry doesn't bring me many recruits these days. He must think highly of your combat skills.
I've been in the shit a long time.
You know your way around the freaks?
Yes, sir. I know as much as anyone, sir.
Good, good. In here. We'll have the doc take a look at you.
Pulse is strong. Good heart rate. Got a pretty nasty burn there. How'd that happen?
Had a run-in with a wood stove.
Wood stove, huh? Who dressed this?
I did.
No está mal. Not bad at all.
Thank you.
Keep it dressed or you're gonna lose that arm. You hear me, amigo?
Yeah, I hear you.
I want you to check back with me in a few days.
Got it.
Well, Doc.
He's fit to serve. Lo hará bien. You doing runs out in the shit?
Sorry, Doc. Ya tiene novia. He's spoken for.
Let me guess. The Wizard Island Witch. Vaya con Dios. Good luck, amigo.
Let's go, son. I normally don't tolerate insubordination, referring to an officer as a witch. But I make exceptions for some of my more eccentric officers.
Yes, sir.
I make exceptions because every man and woman still living has a role to play. Do you believe in God, St. John?
Never gave it much thought, sir.
Well, it's high time that you did. He has a plan for us, all of us. And my part is this.
Sir?
This place. I had a vision. Oh, nothing so grand as those described in the Old Testament. No flaming chariots or burning bushes. I simply woke up one morning before God's plague had rained down upon the world and knew that this was the place.
Crater Lake, Wizard Island.
I call it the Ark. Are you familiar with the story?
Yeah, I mean, yes, sir. I mean, everyone's heard of it.
Indeed. You'd be surprised how few have read the Bible or the Book of Revelations.
You mean Genesis, Noah's story. I mean, that... It's the Book of Genesis, sir.
Yes, of course. Okay, son, let's get you squared away.
Whatever you say.
Now, we don't have much in the way of uniforms, I'm sorry to say, but I think that... Here. Try this on.
Seems to fit.
I'll take that.
Well, if you don't mind, this is a gift from an old friend.
An old friend? Not many of those left anymore, are there?
No, there are not.
Okay, soldier. But I don't want to see you wearing it. You're one of us now. And normally we start new recruits in the rank of private. But since Captain Curry has vouched for your experience in the field, we are starting you out at the rank of corporal.
Congratulations, son.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, let's get you some work.
All right. Now, what was I saying?
You were telling me about the Ark, sir.
Yes, the Ark. What you see here is only a small part of it. Behind us is a whole network of caves and vents that lead from here up to the Cone's Peak. When our work is complete, they will be filled with thousands of seeds, plants, computer files, and books. The world may die, but our achievements in medicine, science, and technology will not die with it.
No, sir.
But the island is more than just an ark, Corporal. It is a stronghold, a fortress. Here at the North Gate, we are stockpiling enough munitions to take the fight to the freaks. We have rifles, grenades, heavy machine guns, and RPGs. We have the equipment to make ammunition, every type, every caliber. This is our mechanical engineering area. If you need your bike repaired, see the officer on duty. And as you can see here, courtesy of the old National Guard, we are building a fleet of trucks and other vehicles. Once the hordes are cleared from the highways, we will begin to rebuild the roads and bridges.
Your slash-and-burn strategy may stop newts and swarmers, but it won't clear the highway. It won't stop the hordes, sir.
We are aware, Corporal. The hordes. The hordes are a different beast entirely, aren't they? But we have a plan.
Plan, sir?
Benjamin Franklin once said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. We are not going to fail. The heart of the army lives here, at the gate, ready to move on my command. These tents house hundreds of women and men, just like yourself, who have pledged and sworn their lives to the fight. But I have something else in mind for you. An assignment that requires more than just the ability to survive in the shit or use a gun. Are you up for it, son?
Yes, sir. Wherever you need me.
You know?
You asked how we were going to defeat the Horde? Let me show you.
Get out of the way.
You okay, Lieutenant?
Oh, hey, Colonel. Sorry about that. Too much acetone in that batch.
Lieutenant Weaver is our chemical engineer. He's working on new ways
to blow shit up.
Defeat the enemy.
Sorry. But, yeah. Name's Weaver. James.
St. John, Deacon.
All this militia shit's just for show, right, Colonel?
Corporal St. John is new to Corey's unit. If you need anything from out in the shit, he's your man.
Oh, shit, yeah. Yeah, there's a couple of things I need.
What are you working on?
Oh, just the new gelling agent combining naphthenic and palmitic acid.
You working on napalm?
Yeah. Yeah. This dude knows his shit.
Just a lucky guess.
Sorry to interrupt.
Oh, anytime. Oh, Colonel. I'm getting real close, Colonel. Very close.
That's good. That's really good.
Where you going next, Colonel? Wizard Island Witch?
That'll be all, Lieutenant. Again, let me apologize for my more eccentric officers.
No need, sir.
We have one final stop. As much as I believe in Lieutenant Weaver's work, what you're about to see could be, I think, our path to victory. In here.
All right, what is this?
Ma'am, I got everything on the requisition form.
Does this look like fabric softener?
No, ma'am.
Okay, why don't you read it?
Active ingredients. Chloroform and A-terpene...
Get out. Get out! I can't do this if I have to do my own supply runs.
I got it covered. Lieutenant Whitaker, this is Corporal St. John. He's a new member of Khoury's unit. He's got some experience out in the shit.
Read this.
What?
Read this. I mean, you can read, can't you?
Active ingredients, chloroform, a-terpenol, benzo alcohol, ethyl acetate.
Good enough. When can he start?
I'll leave you to it. Carry on, Lieutenant.
Leave us.
Sir.
Stand at attention. Dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Hey.
You're dead.
It's okay.
You're dead.
I'm right here.
Wait a second. I don't understand. I couldn't find you.
I thought that you had died, and I.
No, we were overrun. We had to go south. Nero, they said
Nero,
that no one
I
made
found
it out.
O'Brien and
Farewell
I found
was overrun. They said that everybody was
mountain.
Dead.
And I didn't think that
I never thought I would see you again.
See. Hey, listen. Now we can ride out of here. We'll pick a direction. We won't look back. Come
please.
On.
No, Deacon. I can't.
Are they forcing you to stay here?
No, you don't understand. We're fighting a war. Don't you see? This is a war that we can win.
I didn't come here to fight a war.
I can be helpful. I can make a difference, but I can't go with you. I have to stay here. Don't you get it? You can stay here with me. Help me. Look, afterwards, whatever you say, we can go wherever you want.
Colonel's looking for you.
Whatever you say, ma'am.
Wait a second. Your requisition form. Thank you, soldier.